dire merci au Seigneur pour tout ce que lui aussi a fait pour nous et tous ceux et celles qui ont fait le sacrifice de leur vie pour nous autres. Nous sommes réunis ici pour célébrer ce grand acte de foi et de courage pour que nous puissions être ici et célébrer ensemble. So today we gather and we celebrate the mystery that life is to each one of us, that God has given us in each of our hearts, the beauty of His love. And then we know that after the First World War, they said this is the war that would end all wars. And we were hoping they were true. But because we are human beings, it doesn't happen that way. It's still, right at this moment, the civil war in Syria is terrible. It breaks our hearts to see what's happening to human beings. But we who are gathered here today, we say Jesus Himself was the one who died on the cross for us, rose from the dead to give us new life. So hopefully in our hearts today, we give thanks for Jesus' love for each one of us, for all the children who are near the paradise that are here with us. And they also, we give thanks for all our children who have freedom, who have liberty to be part of the Christian community that we are gathered here today. We, as Christians, then we give thanks to God every time we come into the Eucharist, every time we come and say, we give thanks to God for all the gifts He has given to each of our hearts. And also, every time we come to the Eucharist on Sunday, it is the good news that we go to share with one another. The good news that we have life eternal in each of our hearts. The good news that gives us a sense of belonging. Alors, le Seigneur nous donne cette bonne nouvelle dans nos cœurs ce matin pour être ici et célébrer ensemble ce mystère que Dieu fait pour chacun de nous. Et ce Dieu qui est toujours, qui marche avec nous, c'est ce Dieu qui nous a donné Jésus, qui est mort sur la croix et ressuscité. Et maintenant, nous célébrons ensemble la beauté de son œuvre d'amour pour chacun et chacun de nous. Alors, today, also we remember, and when I was in Holland, I seen many of the graveyards, and I was in Bergen-op-Zoom, and at that time I was in Digby area, and they asked me to go and check if I could find some of their relatives, and sure enough, it is all well. The books are all, as you enter, the books are all there to see all the names, where they are from. And I found some people who had given their lives in the war, the Second World War, in from Marshalltown area. Also, I went to Maastricht to see the cemeteries there. And Maastricht is that town right at the end of the town that goes in between Belgium and Germany. And at the end, Maastricht is there. And if you go there, then you can see there's thousands of people who are buried there. One side is the American, and thousands of them died. And then you see on the other side, thousands and thousands of Canadians are buried there. And so it is with that kind of remembering all those who have given their lives that we gather. It is in that kind of attitude that we see the beauty of God's love working today in each of our hearts. I always say, if the war had not ended, where would we be? I don't like to think about it. I rather think that the war did end and that we are here in peace and liberty to celebrate the Eucharist, to celebrate with one another, to know how God worked mysteriously with each one of us, worked mysteriously. have given their lives for us and work mysteriously in the sense of knowing that God is with us. Alors, aujourd'hui, nous voyons la beauté de tous ces grands saints dans la colonne qui dit que des mille et des mille soldats des membres de la force armée canadienne, ils sont là et on dit merci au Seigneur pour ce qu'ils ont fait pour nous, parce que nous sommes heureux d'avoir cette paix, cette liberté de célébrer ensemble. So today is a day of remembering, it is a day of thanksgiving in each of our hearts for all they have done for us, and we say thank you to all of you who have come together to celebrate this Eucharist this morning, so that we can pray that human beings will live in love, in kindness, to help one another. That's what the message of Jesus. We know we are human beings and we are frail. So we are very frail human beings, fragile, and so things do happen sometimes that we don't like. But yet we gather and say thank you to God for giving us the chance to be here and to celebrate.
Rocky.